Hi, this is Charles Hoskinson broadcasting live from warm, sunny Colorado. Always warm, always sunny, sometimes Colorado. Today is December 19th, 2022. It is one of the last days of December, last working weeks of December. Christmas is coming, and then after that, New Year's is coming, and we just move on. It has been a very difficult year in review, let me tell you. You know, markets went from 2.6 trillion in value to under 800 billion. Every week, it seems like we're getting hit with something. Every week, it seems like there's the scandal or the issue. You know, there were things like Luna and Celsius and FTX at the beginning of the year. And I went to the parties and everybody said, these are the future. These guys, they got it all figured out and they know what's going on. And they ask about Cardano and they say, ah, it's a scam. Don't go to Cardano. Don't do anything with Cardano. You're a fool if you do that. But Luna is safe. FTX is safe. Now look where we are at in December. Two of the three, there's criminal charges and the third one probably too. You know, things change very quickly. Crypto went from the darling boy that was going to have a humongous impact on the 2022 midterm election. Y'all remember the red wave that was supposed to happen? Kind of, sort of, not really. $1 billion apparently was thrown around in this election, didn't do much for it. It was supposed to be the next big thing for the arts and all these other domains, and all these new people flooded into the space with very heightened expectations carried over from 2021. And it turned out that wasn't the case. The diehards, they put their nose to the grindstone and they kept building. We got Vossel out this year. We worked really hard, wrote a ton of new papers. We got a great technical vision for Voltaire together, like SIP 1694 and the MBO structure. A lot of discussion about the Constitution. The foundation did a phenomenal job with the summit. You know, we had great events like Consensus this year and Scott Fest this year. So real happy about that. And I'm real happy about the growth metrics in our community. I saw an article that said Solana went from 2,500 active developers to 75. I don't know if the article is verified or not, but there's a lot of this news floating around that everybody's having a hard time with adoption, building, and even the people who had a lot of traction are scaling down a bit. And it's just one of those situations where bear markets tell you who you really are. It's been stressful for everybody. This probably been the most stressful year of my life, because I do a lot. I got a biotech company and a healthcare clinic we've been building, and I raise bison and working on the restaurant. Autoluminescent plants. You know, I got a farm, got some real estate stuff. Then obviously Cardano and all the other things we got going on. And, you know, running this company is like five companies in one, because you got Lace and Prism and Midnight and all these other things like Crypto Bison and our academic research. So managing all of that and then trying to also figure out how to interface with the space. And I've noticed that social media has become increasingly more polarized and toxic and abusive. And that's to be expected because people have lost money and people have become hyper-tribal. And honestly, the only people talking right now are the diehards. And they don't really care about facts. And they don't really care about understanding and collaboration and partnerships. All they really care about is trying to get some small moral victory to justify themselves as the ship's on fire. So you have to deal with that and at the same time make progress and push forward. And if you look at the growth metrics of our ecosystems in particular, we've done great work and they've all grown from transaction volume to native assets to dApp volume. TVL shrunk a bit. Well, value of ADA is down over 73%. So you can have the exact same amount of ADA locked. It's actually grown, but the overall value shrunk. So the TVL shrinks. It's the nature of the game. It's why it's such a terrible measurement. By the way, Bitcoin has zero TVL, if you really think about it, or close to it. I guess you could count the stuff in Lightning as TVL and these other such things in the wrapped coins as TVL, but it's minuscule. But overall, it's been an interesting year. It's been a tough one. And I'm glad to finally have a little bit of time to have a break and go through calm reflection. I can't help but think of last year. That was a wild year. It was fun, but it was really exhausting as well. And I took a week off and, I went to this meditation retreat, the Shambhala Mountain Center, and I spent a week not talking and just sitting there quietly and silently, rejuvenating and recharging. And it's good to do that from time to time. I haven't had the opportunity this year because we've just been so busy. So it's a little unfortunate, and it does show. I'm just off of a two-week fast. I spent 12 days not eating anything at all, and then 2 days refeeding to get back to a state where I could eat things. So I refed over the weekend, and that was a lot of fun. I feel a lot better. Went from 242 to 225, and everything looks really good. And I'm excited to roll that into a protein-sparing modified fast next year, along with a pretty aggressive workout program. And throughout next year, I think I'll get a lot healthier. I'm glad that we got through all of it together. You know, the Cardano community has been great. They've always been vocal and interesting and engaged in a lot of really cool stuff. And it's really nifty to see a lot of the projects. There's been some disappointments like Ardana and Orbis, for example, where they just failed due to colossal mismanagement, poor planning. I met with the founder recently, and I was not thoroughly impressed. And I was extremely upset because normally when you're failing, the people who invest in you, you go to them and say, is there any way we can get a bridge loan or work something out or sell more equity to try to create continuity for the project? You don't wait until you fail and then announce it over Twitter. It just shows the immaturity of the venture. But that's the nature of the game. 80 to 90% of the time, the people fail. And there will be more, always will be. But all things considered, pretty happy with the fact that we've made so much progress and we continue moving forward. The markets as a whole, the industry as a whole, we're headed for some difficult times in 2023. I think we've been pushed into a political reality where one political party got caught with their hand in the cookie jar, getting a lot of money from people like SBF. And now they're overreacting and saying stupid and very dangerous and volatile statements like maybe we should ban crypto. They have no intention of actually doing it, but just by saying it, it causes harm. And it's insulting and patronizing to the enormous set of entrepreneurs who work so hard and have dedicated their lives to this industry. But yet they do say it because that's how politics work. You can just now say whatever you want to say with no consequences. You can bully and harass people. You can accuse people of treason. Like I remember Mitt Romney tweeting that Tulsi Gabbard is guilty of treasonous acts against the United States. She's still an active duty lieutenant colonel in the Army National Guard, served in war a lot more than you ever did, Mittens. But apparently you're accusing her of treason, which, by the way, would be a violation of her commitments to the U.S. Army, and she'd be court-martialed for that. Sitting U.S. Senator just says it, gets away with it. It's the world we live in. It's a world without accountability. It's a world without truth. And it's a world where there are institutions we used to rely upon are morally bankrupt. So we have to do better as an ecosystem, internally and externally. We have to do better as a society. And that's what keeps me around, and that's what keeps me inspired, keeps me going, is the unified belief that the systems we build here and the failures we go through, the foresight the systems have, will inevitably protect people from themselves. And I hope that we continue that threat. CoinDesk recently wrote an article saying we have to return to crypto principles. Of course, we never got reference because we never do. But the truth of the matter is that's been the mantra of Cardano from the very beginning, and why our community, frankly, is so strong and gets stronger when a crisis happens. First principles, evidence-based research. Why are you here? You're here because we want to change the world. It doesn't have anything to do with money. Money doesn't matter anymore. It's just made up pieces of paper. I keep saying it, and you're starting to realize it. Why? Because every time you go to the grocery store, it gets more and more expensive. The price of homes has doubled. Salary hasn't gone up. Everything else getting more expensive. And it's harder and harder to survive off of what you have. And the largest wealth transfer in U.S. history just happened. And no one's going to go to jail about it. wages fell $3.7 trillion over the last 2 years, whereas $3.9 trillion was transferred to the top 500 wealthiest people. How about that? Where's the congressional inquiry into that? I'm waiting. This is going to happen. Maybe Tuesday? No, because they know who feeds them. So we have to go our own way as an industry, and we have to work hard as an industry. And there are some who say money matters to them, but you know what? If I took your family away from you, I took your creature comforts away from you, I took your purpose in life away from you, but gave you $10 million, very quickly, you'd start saying, give me the other stuff back. Or else you don't understand what life is about. Anyway, let's get to your questions. And we might have a surprise guest every now and then.